Hello friends, Richard Eras brings the conclusion of the book Think Like a Monk. It has been a great journey, isn't it? I hope you liked all the videos and this is the conclusion of that book. I am Gajinder Sharma and I'll be covering some key points of the books. Whatever we learned, the way Jay presented, we tried to do our best, we tried to deliver it, we tried to justify it. Now it's conclusion time. Jay Shetty has been very honest with this book and he has said a wonderful thing about, like, in the conclusion. So many wonderful gifts he has given. One of the gifts that he has said that he has given is through his words, through his wisdom, which he has said. See, if you feel that after reading this book everything is going to change suddenly, this is not going to happen. Even after watching all these videos, if you think, or by reading that book, if you think things will change from tomorrow, this is not going to happen. Suddenly life will not take a drastic change. It won't. The patterns need to be broken, like, slowly. So not everything is going to change, but yes, wherever you go, you can take life with you. That's the best line I have heard. Wherever you go, take life with you. Take life with you. That means not everything is going to be according to you, but wherever you go, you can live, right? You can take the life along with you. That's the greatest asset we can have. And that's the best line he has given us. Another thing that he has offered in the conclusion part, that is meditation. Yes, he has given two meditations, that is two death meditations. Now what are they? First is, there are two types of meditation. First type is like imagining you are on deathbed, and second is funeral type. So we'll discuss one by one. The first meditation is, you can easily do it your home. No, it just sounds scary, but it is not scary. What you have to do is, you just sit on a place, just normally sit and just visualize you're sitting on your deathbed. And every night you do this, right? Before going to bed, you do this. You just see, have you accomplished your dreams? Are you happy? Are you satisfied? Are you fulfilled? Just see, if it is your death bed and if you're going there, are you satisfied? Are you happy with this life? If not, then you know what has to be changed, right? This is one of the best meditation you can have. And if you do it for almost 6 weeks, as he says, then something tremendous will happen. Second type is funeral meditation, which is, you just imagine yourself at your own funeral. What you're doing there, you just imagine how you want yourself to be remembered at your funeral. What should people say, what should people think, right? You just don't remember how many people are, like, crying for you or not. You just think how you would want to be remembered, right? So just focus and think what exactly you want, what qualities you want at your funeral, like, what should people talk about, and then see what is the current level. Suppose you want to die as a kind person, like, people should know you as a kind person. Are you kind today? Have you been kind yesterday? See, yesterday we can't fix, but we can fix the tomorrow, right? We can bring a change in tomorrow, right? We need to think, am I kind today? If not, if there is a gap between what I want in my funeral and what I am today, then we know where we have to work, right? So that is the case. We have to reduce this gap daily, on daily basis. You do this kind of meditation. You just think what is the quality with which you want to be remembered, and then you do this. There are a lot to cover, but these are the finest aspects that we think is necessary to convey. So that's we have brought. We hope that you all like this series and you loved and enjoyed. So best wishes from our side, and stay safe. Thank you so much for listening.